So what is USB power delivery? Well, the simple answer is that USB power delivery, or USB PD, enables safe, flexible USB charging up to 100 watts over a full-featured USB-C cable, which is to say, a USB cable that supports up to 10 gigabits per second data transfer and 100 watts power delivery when connected to a similarly full-featured USB-C Thunderbolt 3 or Thunderbolt 4 port. As an added benefit, USB power delivery allows you to transition to a single type of charger for laptops, phones, tablets, and devices with a USB-C or Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4 connection. But that's the quick answer. Actually, there's a fair bit more to power delivery than just more power. Suppose your device doesn't need 100 watts to charge. If it supports USB power delivery, it'll actually negotiate with the system for the required power levels so the device only pulls the appropriate charge. The USB charging capability can even adjust as the needs of the peripheral change. And here's something. The direction of power flow? No longer one way. Now either the device or the peripheral can supply the charge. To put power delivery in practical parlance, let's consider how different wattages affect the time it takes to charge a laptop. But first, we need to quiet some confusion that consistently clamors to the surface when considering how USB charging works. And that's this. Your computer's maximum charging rate is not your computer's only charging rate. I'll assume you're charging through USB-C because you probably wouldn't be here watching this if you weren't. You can actually power up with more or less wattage than your computer's native charger prescribes. For instance, Apple sells a 61-watt USB-C power adapter and a 96-watt USB-C power adapter for their MacBooks. They both work, just at different speeds. To demonstrate, we charged a 14-inch MacBook Pro M1 Pro with a pluggable TBT3 UDZ, which features 96-watt charging, and a pluggable UD6950 PDZ, which offers 60-watt charging. In the first test, charging at 96 watts, our MacBook went from 3% to 100% in an hour and 20 minutes. In our second test, charging at 60 watts, the same MacBook went from 3% to 100% in just 1 hour and 43 minutes. Before we move on, it is worth noting that when we ran these tests, the computer was not under heavy workload. The more you use your computer while it's charging, the longer it'll take to top off the battery. And if you're working on a power-intensive project, like, say, video editing, you may find yourself drawing more power than you're replacing when using a wattage lower than your laptop spec calls for. So what does that experiment mean for you? When setting up your desk, consider a hub or docking station with a simple one-plug solution. And if you're going with that option, consider your daily work habits. How fast do you really need to charge? Just remember, you can safely charge your laptop with a standards-compliant USB-C charger or docking station that provides different wattage than what your system manufacturer provided. But you can usually save a little money with the lower wattage option. One final thought. Although 100 watts is enough to handle most of our charging needs, larger devices, like gaming laptops, still need more power. For that, there's another option called USB Extended Power Range, or USB EPR. EPR can pull in an impressive 240 watts, enough for even the most power-thirsty of laptops. You can learn more about EPR by following the link in the description. As always, if you have questions on connections or comments about anything else, let us know down below or contact us directly at support@pluggable.com, and I reckon we can get you squared away.